On November the 17th, 2010, a father walked into a scene in his Auburn home that threw him into a violent rage, a rage that left his wife dead.
Christopher Smeltzer is now serving 15 to 30 years in prison after pleading guilty to manslaughter under extreme provocation. In his first media interview, Christopher Smeltzer tells our Amy Covino about what he discovered that night.
I missed him every day. I mean, that's hard. You think you're going to get used to it. I don't think you get used to it.
This is a man who says, yes, I killed my wife. But he says the grisly situation he stumbled upon inside this Auburn house sent him into a rage. It took investigators months to piece together the facts.
Mara was on the bed. She was moaning. She had a blue rope tightly around her neck. He described that she was trying to kill herself. He said he picked up a flashlight and struck Mara what he thought 2 to 3 times.
Christopher Smeltzer admits that on the night of November 7th, 2010, he went out for a couple of hours, met a friend. The two smoked crack cocaine, something Smeltzer says he hadn't done since he was just out of high school.
And I made mistakes. I was under a lot of stress. And, you know, I mean, it's, again, another thing I have to live the rest of my life with.
It was just after 9 o'clock when Smeltzer got home. He'd picked up aspirin for his wife, Mara, while he was out, and went right to the bedroom to check on her.
As soon as I opened the bedroom door, I noticed my son on the floor face down, and that's when I knew something was wrong. And I turned him over and knew right away he was gone, and I pretty much lost it after that.
Smeltzer says he knew his wife had killed their son and was now killing herself. His rage took over. It was only after Smeltzer struck his wife multiple times that he realized his 8-year-old daughter, Mercy, was also on the bed.
And I tipped her over and she was the same as Mason. So I thought at that point, basically my whole family was gone.
And in that moment where you walk in on this nightmare-ish scene, you go into a rage. Do you think to call anyone for help?
It didn't even cross my mind at the moment, you know.
And then after you'd hit Mara, again, no calling for help.
I honestly, truly thought my whole family was passed. So I didn't want to live at that point.
He ingested all the pills he could find. Xanax, allergy medicine, a variety of prescriptions that Mara had. He never expected to wake up.
I don't know what time it was when I came to, but I came to Mercy being with me on the couch.
Mercy survived. A ligature still around her neck. A 911 call set the investigation in motion. Salacious details that had many asking, what would you do?
I never denied the facts of what I did, and like I still say to this day, I probably could have handled things different, but it's just, I don't think anybody knows how they're going to react to something like that.
Smeltzer describes his wife as a tortured woman who struggled with depression and mental illness. Her journals were filled with writings about death and fears that her children would be taken away.
Extreme ups and downs, emotional roller coaster, anger, sadness, depression. Sometimes she wouldn't get out of bed for days.
Did you love her?
Yes, very much so.
All the way up to the end, all the way up to that last day, you loved her?
Yes.
Chris Smeltzer says he did not want to put Mercy or any of the family through the emotional ordeal of testifying. Mara's stepsister was granted custody of Mercy, a decision that Smeltzer says he agreed with at the time. But after an audio recording of his daughter was played at his sentencing last year, Smeltzer is concerned.
My memories of the rest of that night are so scary, I just want to forget them. But I can't. My life will never be the same.
I don't think it was something that an 8-year-old produced by herself and right off on her own.
Your family would like to see Mercy.
Yes.
You would like
so.
To see Mercy.
Yes. No.
And you've been cut off.
Yes.
Christopher Smeltzer says he'll be almost 50 by the time he gets out of prison, and all he wants is the chance to be part of his daughter's life.
Well, I already feel as though, you know, my son's life has been taken away from me, and now I feel as though I'm missing hers.
Mara's family declined on several occasions to comment on the record for this story. Several members of Mara's family expressed skepticism to News 9 about what really happened that night. Christopher Smeltzer is serving a 15 to 30 year sentence with the chance to reduce his time by 5 years if he earns a college degree. Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.